The cars now are completing the green flag landings. The scheduled race distance is 20 laps. I think everybody's going to be keen to ensure A, they don't go over the curbs, and B, they don't damage their nice new cars. New shaped Clio, or you can go to a showroom and buy the shape Clio. Red lights go on and out. And as they head towards Paddock Hill Bend for the first time, it's pole position man Alex Morgan who snatches the lead. And for second place, it's side by side with Paul Rivett trying to assert himself. Paul Rivett has got one car going sideways and points a long way up the hill towards Druids. But about to hit Paul Rivett. Well, he's got that out of his system that season, perhaps. And the car just went sideways. I've got another one going sideways here. That was an unforced error. Whereas in Paul Rivett's case, it wouldn't be like him to have a spin. But we reckon there's a bit of contact with Mike Bushell there that sent Paul Rivett sideways. So Paul Rivett now with a load of ground to make up as the car's come through at the end of the first lap. Paul Rivett, a distant last. The car's undamaged by the looks of things, and he's now going to drive the door handles off it. In the lead is Alex Morgan, in second place is Ron Smith, third is Josh Cook, and sixth on the grid by Bushell is fourth, having been involved in that incident with Paul Rivett, James Culver, in the next number three, he passes the next number five. The tenth is Ron Smith, and the fourth is eight, ninth is Sir Helen Mandel, tenth is Mark Howard, and Gordon Eagle's got caught up in all that as well. He lost time on the first lap, he's down in 11th place for Craig Kilmer and Paul Rivett in the last two places. Now, predictions over 20 laps. Half of them still remaining. Where will Paul Rivett end up? He could.